vibranium. It's an amazing fictional metal in the Marvel Cinematic Universe, with the ability to absorb any kinetic energy directed towards it, and all vibrations. As I mentioned when examining Captain America's shield, that latter property would be deadly. It would freeze anyone that came into contact with it down to absolute zero, and then cause them to vaporize. So, ignoring that aspect, let's move on to Black Panther, because he has a suit made of the stuff. As Marvel artist Brian Stelfreeze says, in the Marvel Universe, vibranium has always been this material that absorbs kinetic energy. And any tiny bit of physics knowledge will tell you, you can't just absorb energy. You've got to change it into something else. So to the rest of the world, they only know vibranium as something that can absorb energy. But to the Wakandan scientists, they not only know that vibranium will take in energy, but they know how to get the energy back out. And that's something we actually see in the Black Panther movie.
Hey, look at your suit. You've been taking bullets, charging it up with kinetic energy.
But I reckon I figured out how it works.
You show off.
Some materials are able to take their internal stresses, caused for instance by objects with kinetic energy hitting them, and convert that into usable electrical energy. This is known as piezoelectricity, from the Greek word piezein, which means to squash. Now, piezoelectricity is a feature of some crystals, such as quartz, but you might be thinking, well, vibranium's a metal, so that rules that out. But in physics, what we mean by a crystal is any material whose atoms or molecules are arranged in a perfectly repeating pattern or lattice. And that's certainly true of how ions are arranged within metals. A lot of crystals have symmetric arrangements of all their atoms within their repeating pattern. But those in piezoelectric crystals usually don't. While the atoms may not be symmetrically arranged, their electrical charges are usually perfectly balanced. But this balance is rather delicate, and any slight change to the arrangement of the atoms can upset it. Squeezing or stretching the crystal deforms the structure, leading to an imbalance in the charges. Add this atomic effect up over all the repeating patterns within the crystal, and you can get a sizable electrical voltage out. This is how I reckon Black Panther's suit actually works. Every impact it takes deforms the vibranium, turning that kinetic energy into usable electrical energy, which can then be stored. This is an idea known as energy harvesting, and researchers are looking to apply in all sorts of places. For instance, even the streets could be made of piezoelectric crystals, charging up energy as people and cars go by. The vibranium itself could also do that conversion from electrical energy back into kinetic energy, because piezoelectric crystals also exhibit the reverse piezoelectric effect. Apply a voltage across the crystal, and the atoms will rearrange themselves to balance out again. This is something we use all over the place in small-scale motors and speakers. So the ability to convert kinetic energy directed towards a material into something useful isn't some fancy high-tech Wakandan science using a very weird material. It's so run-of-the-mill that in fact you've had it the whole time in your smartphones, speakers and microphones. Even your car's lighter does exactly the same thing. Thanks so much for watching this video and joining me at the Barbican Conservatory. I hope you enjoyed it. Please do check out some other videos of mine on my channel and subscribe if you want to get the latest one. Thanks a lot.